Konkan Maratha Entrepreneurs presents Champions of Innovation Series.
Hello everyone. A very warm good evening to all of you. Amgele Konkan Maratha samajatle sagle janti loka ani bandhi bandhuno namaskar. KME mhanlar Konkan Maratha Entrepreneurs ya group tarfe aaj ya sahavya webinar saglyan swagat asa. गेलपटी आम्ही डॉक्टर विनायक नाईक बरा चर्चा केली आणि सगळ्यांच्या खूप बरो प्रतिसाद मिळतो. आफ्टर एन एनरिचिंग सेशन विथ डॉक्टर विनायक नाईक कपल ऑफ मंथ्स अगो, टुडे कोकण मराठा एंटरप्रेनर्स ऑल्सो नोन एज KME प्रेझेंट्स इट्स सिक्स्थ वेबिनार एज पार्ट ऑफ इट्स चॅम्पियन्स ऑफ इनोव्हेशन सीरीज. एम्पॉवरिंग आत्मनिर्भरता इज द टॅगलाइन अँड दॅट्स व्हॉट वी प्लॅन टू डू एज पार्ट ऑफ कारवा. अ क्विक इंट्रोडक्शन. It's an initiative of second generation of entrepreneurs and the whole aim is to encourage entrepreneurship within our community. It will try to provide a platform for sharing knowledge and providing networking opportunities for new and existing entrepreneurs. We realized that there are a lot of entrepreneurs within the community, right? And many times we are not aware what they are doing, right? So this is a small attempt to get them together and to give that networking so that with the help of each other, with that symbiosis, they can reach greater heights. So let me give a quick background of what's in store today before we start. As konabar ulaitale he je thodi si maiti dita aaj amgele jo speaker asa to Mr. Bibi Rane la chalo asa. For those who are not aware, Mr. Bibi Rane he Konkan Maratha samajache Mumbai che founding member ase. Pura samajatle pahile गॅजेटेड गव्हर्नमेंट ऑफिसर. रिटायरमेंट नंतर त्यांनी सदाशिवगड कम्युनिटी हॉल आणि एक सेव्हिंग्स बँक उभारली. आ स्पीकर टुडे इज द सन ऑफ मिस्टर बीबी राणे. फॉर दोज ऑफ हू आर नॉट अवेअर, मिस्टर बीबी राणे वॉज वन ऑफ द फाउंडिंग मेंबर्स अँड बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक्स ऑफ कोकण मराठा समाज इन मुंबई. द फर्स्ट गॅजेटेड गव्हर्नमेंट ऑफिसर फ्रॉम कोकण मराठा कम्युनिटी अँड आफ्टर हिज रिटायरमेंट हॅज हेल्प बिल्ड अ कम्युनिटी हॉल अँड अ स्मॉल सेव्हिंग्स बँक ऍट सदाशिवगड. सो व्हॉट आर वी गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट टुडे अँड Who is the visionary speaker we have today on board? Many times we complain about government processes, especially efficiency of the government. Government karyabhar mhanla amka dista ki khup vel lagtalo, ami khup vela complain karta unknowingly. Pan tumka lakshat yetu hotale ki gele 10-15 varshat khup kitkite badlav zala ani khup bare badlav zala. Still a long way to go, but a lot of things have changed. Our government bodies in partnership with different companies have been slowly transforming the landscape of governance. Khup he sagle companies mein khup kitkite parivartan hadti asat and one of the front runner in bringing this change is ABM Knowledge Well, which was founded by a very visionary person from our very home Karwar. So let's look at maybe some of you have had a look at the video. I'll give you a quick snapshot of the inspiring story of ABM Knowledge Well. It truly symbolizes perseverance over the last 20 plus years. Since 1998, ABM has been providing solutions that have formed a bridge between the citizens and government. One of the few companies focused primarily on e-governance, a solid mixture of latest technology plus understanding of the government function. And I think most importantly, a very strong understanding of the engineering or the re-engineering that is required for the government processes that has made this possible. The aim of ABM is not just to automate, but to improve efficiency by bringing in knowledge. Hence, I think maybe the name is ABM Knowledge. Winner of Economic Times Best Tech Brands for 2020 and 2021, ABM operates at a pan-India level. You will be amazed to know that almost 25% of the municipalities in India and 28% of the smart cities in India are customers of ABM. In last 10 years, ABM has seen almost 10-fold increase in citizen services to multiple urban local bodies in India. So without much ado, let's welcome on the screen Mr. Prakash Rane, founder and CEO of ABM Knowledge Well. Welcome, Prakash.
थँक यू व्हेरी मच किरण. थँक यू व्हेरी मच की तुम्ही KME प्लॅटफॉर्माचेर म्हाका इन्वाईट केला अँड आय एम क्वाईट हॅपी टू नो दॅट यू फील मी कॉम्पिटंट इनफ टू बी पार्ट ऑफ दिस फोरम. कारण या फोरमवर ह्याच्या पहिले जे लोक येऊन गेला होता, दे आर द पीपल हुम आय लुक अप टू. सो थँक यू व्हेरी मच अँड होप दॅट यू हॅव नॉट मेड अ मिस्टेक. सो लेट्स गो फॉर द गुड कॉन्वर्सेशन एज वी गो अहेड.
Thank you, Prakash, and welcome again onto the screen. So I'll start with the first of the questions, right, that kept coming to my mind when I heard about EPM, right? The general perception during the late 1990s and early 2000s, and that's when I started my career in IT, and that's why I'm very curious. So the general perception was that true digitalization is happening in the Western world and not really in India. That's where even the prime focus of companies like TCS, Infosys, C2. The very few players that were known for governance were maybe CMC, CMS, etc. Right? In such a times, what made you start as an entrepreneur? That too at such an early age?
See, there are two parts to your question. First thing, what you're asking is why I felt like being an entrepreneur. Second, probably could be why government sector. Let me address the first part. I have been always wanting to be an entrepreneur. I never worked. I did my engineering and I did my management. I never worked. I always felt that if I start working, I mean, this philosophy may not hold good now. If I start working and get used to collecting a salary check on the first of every month, then I may not be able to come out of that area of comfort. पहिले दोन तीन चार वर्ष पगार मिळाल्यानंतर आबोबाप पहिले लर्न कर म्हणून सांगतले. लर्न केल्यानंतर एक दोन वर्षानं आता आम्ही आजी आजोबाकडून जातलो म्हणून विचारतले. वन्स यू स्टार्ट गेटिंग रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज, इट बिकम्स लिटल डिफिकल्ट टू टेक रिस्क. अँड इफ यू डोंट टेक रिस्क अँड इफ यू डोंट लिव्ह युअर एरिया ऑफ कम्फर्ट झोन, देन यू डोंट रिअली गिव्ह युअर बेस्ट टू द ॲस्पिरेशन विच यू हॅव. त्याच्यामुळे आय थॉट आय विल get into business without working anywhere. That is what I thought. That is how I would like to answer the first part of your question. Do you want me to take the government segment issue now, or do you want to take it later on?
Yeah, in fact, starting as an entrepreneur was one thing, right? But would like to understand, and I think that's the question that has come from a lot of audience also, that what was your driving factor? What really inspired you to focus on the government sector?
See, it's like this. When I started business somewhere around 1998, when I started my software business, that pahile I tried my hardware business with good support from our own successful entrepreneurs like Kamla Gibbou and all. I realized that there are a lot of companies which are doing the business. Like Y2K was those days, if you remember, they're Y2K jobs. In the sense, you catch hold of some Micro Focus people, COBOL people, and you export them. That is how most of our IT industry has found its feet. But that point of time, I thought if I join the bandwagon, I'll be lost. I'll be just one of the many who also ran. So I was supplying hardware to government during those days. And I used to find that while they buy the hardware, they do not really reach the logical end. लॉजिकल एंड म्हणणार तेमगेल ॲक्टिव्हिटीज कम्प्युटराईज जाऊ जाय आशिले आणि तेमकां प्रोडक्टिव्हिटी वाढू जाय आशिली आणि द हॅसल्स विच सिटीजन फेसीस वाईल डिलिंग विथ गव्हर्नमेंट ते कमी जाऊ जाय आशिले, किंवा द ड्रजरी ऑफ रेपिटेटिव्ह वर्क्स विच गव्हर्नमेंट एम्प्लॉई डू त्या कमी जाऊ जाय आशिले. सो आय वॉज नॉट फाइंडिंग दॅट हॅपनिंग. सो इट वॉज अ टिपिकल सिच्युएशन वेन यू गो टू आयलंड अँड फाईंड नोबडी वेअर्स चप्पल, वेदर यू टेक अ डिसिजन टू पुट अ फॅक्टरी देअर बिकॉज नोबडी इज वेअरिंग अ चप्पल, or you decide to come back from the market because nobody is wearing a chappal. Since there was nobody who was focusing on government, I thought I might as well look at government because the competition will be lesser, number one, because all big boys were very busy and are still very busy in looking westwards. That was one reason. So I will have opportunity to learn because I don't come from a information technology background. By education, I'm a chemical engineer. So I thought I will get opportunity, but after doing management, I became a generalist. So one reason was I didn't want to be also ran and to be part of the crowd. Second was I thought there is nobody paying attention to government segment, hence the competition will be less. Mm-hmm. And thirdly, mark this like maka learn karuk for well milta lo, because this is not where I'll be immediately judged by customer because there was no worthwhile competition. So these are, and finally, we must remember one thing, ki khanso business khub hod kehna jata when government becomes its buyer. Whether it is defense, whether it is manufacturing, whether it is anything. So a real business really gets big when government becomes a buyer. Mm-hmm. This is largely true. Ashini ke, this is the only truth. But this is largely true. So that also had in my mind that if government becomes a customer and government starts budgeting for computerization of their activity, that time it was not even called e-government. I think Bill Gates came somewhere around 2000 in India, where he probably first coined the term e-government. From there onwards, we actually moved on to giving the nomenclature called e-government. So these are the four or five reasons, Marcus, this lucky I should get into government sector.
Interesting. In fact, very interesting to know that the e-governance term itself was not.
Yeah. Those days, actually, TCS and NIC, National Informatics Center, and TCS. And TCS is now it is part of TCS, CMC, okay, as you rightly mentioned. Those were the companies which were doing government computerization. But people were not very excited to do that. You know, the reasons are obvious. It was not that I had found a secret sauce which nobody else had found. It is not an easy business. And I don't still call it easy business. It is not easy business. But it's a good business if you understand the nuances. So in that particular thing, what I feel is TCS, NIC, the competition was of very large people. And I could have found my own niche. And that is how I got into, otherwise it was really, nobody was there in that field.
Correct. In fact, I had actually joined CMC. CMC was my first company. I did work with the government of Maharashtra. So I can totally relate and understand the challenges that are there in that sector. Excellent. So given the background that you said, right, and you came from a different background, you had a very steep learning curve, right, in understanding and learning from the IT perspective. I'm very sure in the initial years, there must have been some tipping point, right, where you might have almost felt like giving up. If there was, and how did you really overcome that challenge?
See, I was hell-bent on doing business. So there was no time where I felt like not doing business. There could be extreme moments where I questioned my own vision, where I questioned my conviction, ki hao je karta je barobar karta gaya na. कारण तिथले एफर्ट करणं जर हा एक्सपोर्ट बिझनेसातून वत आशिलो तर माका एक्स वाय झी काइंड ऑफ अ रेव्हेन्यू अँड प्रॉफिट्स मेळटा आशिले आणि ह्या बिझनेस मग मेळटा काय ना दॅट वॉज सो आय वॉज व्हेरी क्लिअर आय वील डू नथिंग बट बिझनेस सो देर वॉज नो रिग्रेट्स आर देर वॉज नो मोमेंट्स वेन आय फेल्ड वेदर आय शूड कंटिन्यू डुईंग बिझनेस ऑर नो फ्रॉम दॅट पॉईंट ऑफ व्ह्यू आय वॉज नॉट एट अ स्ट्रेच एनी टाईम परंतु हा जो बिझनेस करताना त्यांचं सुद्धा कठीण आशिलं एक की उरता की इफ यू कम आउट विथ इनोव्हेटिव्ह कन्सेप्ट the biggest challenge in government is they can't buy unless they follow a process. And when they follow a process, they need competition. Single tender aile, the single tender vikat kash ghetale because they are not able to discover the price. And in government, process is more important than outcome sometimes. How the concept artalo, people concept like Setu or concept like Citizen Facilitation Center, which I had brought somewhere in 1999-2000. I had actually developed a solid product for computerization of entire Mantralaya those days. Multiple. Then I found the reason why they are not able to buy it from me, they are not able to compare what I am doing with competition. So, you might have heard there are some methods like Swiss challenge method. Swiss challenge method is that suppose you have a new concept, you have a government, but you misuse it. समजा तुमच्याकडे एक इनोव्हेटिव्ह कन्सेप्ट असा आणि त्या कन्सेप्ट इनोव्हेटिव्ह असेल निमित्तानं गव्हर्नमेंट प्रोसेसात यू विल नॉट बी एबल टू कम्पेअर द प्राईस सो व्हॉट डू यू डू तो इन स्विस चॅलेंज मेथड कित करतात की तुमगेल जे कन्सेप्ट असा ते पब्लिश करतात अँड पीपल आर आस्ड इफ दे कॅन डिलिव्हर दिस पर्टिक्युलर काइंड ऑफ अ मॉडेल प्रोजेक्ट व्हॅल्यू अँड ॲट व्हॉट प्राईस प्रिझ्युमिंग दॅट देर इज अ फेअर bidding, you are have the first right of refusal to match the L1. But amgel ankit asa ki kon kiti price quote karta tyaje kai hishob na. But this works where every bidder is a very serious bidder, does proper calculation of all the costs. तजावन हा खूप हंग चालला. द पॉइंट आय वॉज फीलिंग फ्रस्ट्रेटेड ऍट मेनी टाइम्स वॉज व्हॉट्स द पॉइंट ऑफ कमिंग आउट विथ समथिंग विच नो बडी हॅज डन अर्लियर, नॉट एबल टू फाइंड एक्सेप्टन्स, कारण गव्हर्नमेंटाक कॉम्पिटिशन ना म्हण. आय कॅन जनरेट कॉम्पिटिशन फॉर माय प्रॉडक्ट. सो दॅट वॉज समटाइम्स बिकमिंग व्हेरी फ्रस्ट्रेटिंग. And that was one time, but then I kept moving. See, this business is actually a paradigm shift. म्हणणार आता समजा तुमचा ब्रिज बांधून उरलो, तुम्ही जमीन घेतात आणि कॉन्ट्रॅक्टर अपॉइंट करतात आणि कॉन्ट्रॅक्टर ती जमीन घेतल्यानंतर ब्रिज कन्स्ट्रक्शन चालू करता आणि ब्रिज कन्स्ट्रक्शन चालू केल्यानंतर तुमच्या क्वालिटी इन्स्पेक्टर्स उरतले, तुमच्या कोणी ऑथॉरिटी इंजिनियर उरतलो, हु विल कम अँड मॉनिटर द प्रोजेक्ट, दे विल मॉनिटर द डिझाईन. It is not like that in e-government. In e-government, you are changing the way people behave. You are changing the paradigm in which they are working. So you want people, I mean, there are instances where accounts department was hell-bent on having the trial balance look like their actual book. In the sense that तुम्ही तुमच्या की जेणे अकाउंट्स करतात त्यांना खबर उरतले, ते सकल दोन रेड लाईन मारतात, तो डे एंड किंवा इयर एंड. So they were unwilling to accept any other format than the way they were writing their book. They wanted an A3 size format. They wanted red double line. It was so painful that time because people are not able to accept that what I am writing, I cannot see, but it will exist. So I have moved into from an area where an account person will ask a question, ki how ji entry keli asa ti mag disna. So how do I be sure that what will be reproduced is what I have entered? Imagine, then one of the IS officers had asked me in a quiet confidence after the meeting, ki Prakash, hi IT apan mantoy exactly kay aite manje, to kay aite IT manje ka income tax hai kay aite. This is a question asked to me by a income tax officer, by a government of IS officer somewhere around in 1990. So the frustrations were not because I took a decision to do business. The frustration sometimes came because I think I was ahead of time in terms of what I was trying to sell and what problem I was trying to solve. So those were the point where I thought many times, but I kept doing. To be very honest, I knew that it can't be wrong. I know that as a citizen, I suffer when I go to government offices. My father has worked as a government servant. I have seen his life. So I know there is a problem to solve. The question is, when will there be equal amount of urge and need? मागची गरज असतात इथली तर गव्हर्नमेंटा गरज. दॅट पिरियड वॉज अ पिरियड ऑफ फ्रस्ट्रेशन. दॅट इज व्हॉट आय कॅन से.
अगेन आय थिंक व्हेरी इन्स्पायरिंग, बिकॉज गिवन द सिच्युएशन इट वॉज रिअली अ हार्ड जॉब टू कीप गोईंग, राईट? एस्पेशली मेनी टाइम्स वी से की कॉम्पिटिशनामुळे प्रॉब्लेम जाते असा, बट कॉम्पिटिशन नशील आणि अवेअरनेस नशीलमुळे जो प्रॉब्लेम जातो, दॅट इज ऑल्सो I think that was a challenge that you faced every day. So we have few questions which are more with respect to budding entrepreneurs. Ja ata IT kitri ek plan business karte asa, not necessarily IT but in general kitri business karte asa, temche tarfe thode se questions asa. So one of the questions is, with the latest technology nowadays, are budding entrepreneurs come up with a unique solution but many times don't know how to approach the target market? So what is your view on this?
See, if I understood right, your question is, we have created a solution and how do we socialize it, or how do we sell it, or how do we market it?
Correct.
See, we need to see it from both ways. Now, let's look at a market which Apple has captured. Now, the Steve Jobs, what was their vision? To give in your hand a machine, a handset, which will become a cult and you will be able to get hooked on so much that you will become a loyal customer of Apple. There they knew what are the problems with the current handsets, so it was a fairly generic product. Now if that Apple could do that, because they had that time, they had a right team, right amount of money by the time they came out with iPhone and iPod. But normally I would feel that barring these kind of products which are generically applicable, we cannot create a use case and then go to market. you need to look at the market and create the use case. You cannot solve the problem and then find out who has the problem. You need to find out the problem and then find the solution. What is business after all? Business after all what? It is solving somebody's problem. Mm. I mean, you are solving somebody's problem, but either the problem which nobody knows exists, like Uber. Nobody knew that there was a space. Nobody knew that there could be aggregator. Nobody knew, but somebody thought about it. He delivered a solution. That is, he solved a problem. Either we should be so sure that the problem which I'm solving is well known to me. I have experience, my friends have experience. Subject matter expertise. तशी जर केस उरली आणि जर तुम्ही यूज केस तयार केली तर तुमको खूप शॉर्टचे पडणार बिकॉज यू नो यू आर सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लेम फॉर हुम. पण तुम्ही जर इफ यू आर इन लव विथ युअर आयडियाज अँड इफ यू आर क्रिएटेड अ प्रॉडक्ट बिकॉज यू लव युअर प्रॉडक्ट देन यू माइट गेट डिसअपॉइंटिंग रिस्पॉन्स. कारण तुमक किती आवडता दॅट इज नॉट द इश्यू. तुम्ही ज्या मार्केटसाठी जर तयार केलं त्यामध्ये आवडतं काय ना तो दिस इज अ व्हेरी स्टँडर्ड कॅच. मेनी पीपल आय हॅव सीन in my company also, when they work on product architecture, they love what they are doing so much that they completely lose the track of ami jachcha sathi tayar karta ka tamko te jayega na man. So my response to your question will be, you need to identify the market segment, anchor customer or anchor population for whom you are solving the problem. Meet these people, collect, do the necessary surveys, do some kind of a alpha beta kind of experiment, make a group of friends, ask them to use your product, you call it alpha launch, see how they are responding, and then you launch the project. So you cannot make the product and then look for market. You look at the market, understand the problem, then develop the use case, then it becomes relatively easier to socialize your ideas or sell your product. That's what I feel.
Thank you. So that's line search, Jeremy. Just as an extension of this, let's say someone has a product and maybe there is, they see the need somewhere in the market, right? But the startup is still small. Temka ozun te name medil na, nala credit medil na, nadala kit manta teka, live customer medil. So in such a case, will you recommend ki a small startup should join hands with a well-established company to use their brand for selling the solution?
See, I was part of a NASSCOM domestic council and also part of a regional NASSCOM council. I worked on many startup initiatives. This is very standard problem faced by startups. There are three problems which startups face. One is market access. Second is access to finance. And third is policy advocacy. Policy advocacy means governmental policy. Atari governmental policy ayalat. For example, in cybersecurity products, the government has said you can buy the preferential market access for cybersecurity companies who make products in India. Policy advocacy means this kind of policy changes. Finance access has become much easier now compared to what it was even 3 to 4 years back. There are VCs, there are incubators, there are angel investors. There are multiple forums where you can go and pitch your idea. So finance also is not as big problem if you are solving a problem which excites somebody. Third, the biggest problem they face is market access. Ata market access kartana, one of the easiest way is to piggy ride on large brands. The problem I used to find during those days when I used to speak to CIOs of various segments, they mi mantale ki aami tyachkan ghevu tayar asat pan ti company phal band padla kit kartale. Idea bari asa, startup asa, magile critical operation asa tegel product getle. I am more on hardware, software. There can be obviously proprietary hardware products, there can be different versions of solutions, but I am more currently talking about software solutions, those kind of solutions made by us. So under these circumstances, it is quite challenging to do that. One can definitely use the route of system integrators or large companies to do that. But how do you negotiate that is very important. Whose IP is it? Are they white labeling, or are they going to say that this has been done by XYZ company so that you build your resume? One of the biggest problems we start to face is that they can't build a resume. They can't say, I have sold here and there, because wherever they sell, like the by using the mode which you asked just now, they don't have visibility. They don't say, I sold. The SI doesn't say that I have sold a product of ABC company. That doesn't suit them. They white label and sell it. So to answer your question, yes, it is the right. It is one of the ways to do that, but you need to have a few things very clear. One is, what is the quid pro quo? In the sense, you need to make money, right? You can have best of the ideas, but if you don't have money, it's not going to go forward. So is the IP yours? Is there kind of a anti-cannibalization pact which you are doing with the SI? Are you reasonably unique that the SI cannot dump you once you get the orders while taking your specification, your price? There are very standard, mundane business risk analysis which we have to do. But yes, this is one of the ways you can do, as long as you have no fear of your idea being cannibalized or you being shortchanged, for which, for example, Microsoft was extremely notorious for doing that. They will go to a small company, add their product into their operating system or some other system, and then very quickly develop that kind of a product and create a competition for that product. So there are no easy answers to the question which you are asking. But yes, if you have a good idea, and if SI is willing to sell your product, it's a question of doing some fine-tuning of some conditions like retaining IP, trying to add your name into that particular product so that you can use that as a reference somewhere else. Those kind of care, they are standard business risk which you need to evaluate. See, what happens is, I used to have one gentleman called as KK. He was Mindtree's managing director. KK was in our group. So I was always debating that if a business startup has idea, they must be commercially sound to do what they want to. Otherwise, what kind of a businessman they are? So after adequate deliberation, he said that is wrong, and I agree with that. He said there are people who have bright ideas, but they are commercially extremely weak. So at this point of time, it will be advantageous to take somebody's help. Some advisor you can take in stitching your commercial agreement. Don't go all by yourself and your understanding of the risk there. Because you may be technically very sound. You may be a good techie. You might have extremely good solution. But commercially, you might fall weak and you might make a mistake. So you can take this route. But while taking the route, if you're a techie, if your orientation is non-commercial, then better take help of somebody. There are enough kind of outsourced CFOs and those kind of people which you get. Take their help, stitch a good commercial agreement and move on.
Thank you, Prakash. I think that was very detailed and very helpful. While we were talking about that, I mean, ulite ashit prashna parite ashilo je audience ekin janela. It's very related asa. And maybe you covered some bit of it. This is from Dayanand Pawar from Lumbini. Please give your top 5 tips for young entrepreneurs in 2021. So this is more generic and not necessarily with respect to IT.
See, first and foremost, I mean, this question is, I may not be able to count 5 or 4 or 3, but let me see what comes to my mind. First and foremost is, we need to have the fire in the belly. Fire in the belly to do business and to do it at by understanding the risk. So we need to ask ourselves, am I doing business because I'm not getting a job? Or am I doing business because I'm getting a job, but I feel frustrated when my boss questions me, or I don't get to push my ideas or my initiatives, and I think I can do better. So you need to be sure whether you are having the necessary fire in the belly. This is the first and foremost thing. That's a starting point. Second thing is, it's important to be strong. It is not that important to insist that everybody in your ecosystem should perceive you as a strong. What I mean is, if you are strong and if you conserve your resources, you can use it when there is a crisis. But I have seen people, as soon as they launch their offices, launch their businesses, they throw a grand party, they hire an office which is fairly expensive in terms of rent. They have a lot of functions. In very plain and simple words, there is a tendency to show off. Not show off what you don't have, to show what you have. I have realized it's more important to be strong rather than to insist ki tumgel adubaje lokak tumi strong disu jay man baki lokak strong asa gay na te dakon divchi garaj na tumi je ulle ta tumi uru jay and conserve your strength for your challenging times. So this is the second thing which I have learned. Third thing is we always use this cliche, there is no shortcut to success, Ashmanata. So that cliche is not as relevant nowadays, because if you work smartly, there is a smart cut to success. So you need to be very sure ki tumhi je methods vapartat te methods kitle smart asat. The same thing which you are doing, are you extremely sure that you are using all the resources that is available in today's world? Kan ami tana business suru keltana information was at premium, getting information was cutting edge. Go to the days of pre 1991 days. Getting a license was more important than having the capability to manufacture. So like that, information, and there are several resources which are today available. So are you a hard working person or are you a smart working person? You must be very sure about that whether you are doing hard work or smart work. Then it comes to values. I personally feel that the sustainable business will come only if you stand for something. If you don't stand for something, you have a risk of falling for everything. So you need to decide, what do you stand for? Whether it is your quality, whether it is your business ethics, whether it is your partnering ethics. There are various ways in which you can decide. So I feel it is very important to have something that you stand for, which you can call as ethics, which you can call as a value system. So these are the things which come to my mind based on the mistakes which I have done in the past and what I have learned from discussing with other people. Last thing what I have realized is that the sound advice does not necessarily come from people who are perceived, seen as successful. Amki dista ki to successful zalo asa mhanta te je uletal te barobar urtale. Maybe to je ulet te barobar urtal sudha. Just look around. Don't think if you have a friend who is not as well educated as you are, or a father or a mother or a brother or a sister. There are so many people who have bright ideas and are doing excellent job. So don't rush for advice only from those people who are stamped as successful people, because there are several people around you. So giving advice is not a fiefdom of those people who are perceived as successful by others. You can get right advice if you just look around you, right from the smallest people in terms of financial or intellectual ability to the senior most person. So the last point that comes to my mind is, look for advice and good things around you. There are plenty. Once you become successful, all the mistakes which you have done are either downplayed, or those mistakes suddenly turn out to be winning secret sauce. It is not like that. Finally, I believe success is one of the best accidents that happens to many people who do not come from a background of Ambanis or Tatas or Birla, those kind of people. So I have a very very crude view on even what I am doing now, that if I am perceived to be successful, which I humbly have serious reservations on calling myself a successful entrepreneur, and this is a fairly honest and not a pompous view, I feel that people who are budding entrepreneurs can also get extremely valuable advice from those who have failed in their business, from those who have failed in their relationships, from those who have made huge mistakes in their lives. So value their advice as much as you value the advice of those who you feel should be followed.
Thank you, Professor. I think that last statement is especially very much valuable. Right? Many times, and I think it's very natural. We tend to ask people who are successful, but many times I think failures have got a very good amount of advice. Couple of questions which are more with respect to government sector, again with respect to entrepreneurs. Prashna asa ki aachya jagat, will you really recommend a new entrepreneur to enter the government sector? Or do you think at this moment it is only for established players? How to approach, since it seems like such a vast ocean?
See, I have no choice but to give an answer. There is a serious question which has come. First of all, those who are establishing government business had entered government business someday or other when they were not established. So they are established today because they entered into that business, they have survived. See, there are, whether you should do business in government or no depends on several things. Several means actually several things. Let's look at few of those things which come to top of my mind. What is the meaning of doing business with government? First foremost, the thought which comes to our mind is corruption. That if I do business with government, I have to do a lot of palm. It is not fully correct. It is not fully incorrect. Second thing which comes to our mind is, government kitha vish mandlara, I don't know how much time it will take. Pesh mag mental gaya na, can pesh mental hai. I find that government procurement depends on a few principles. First is the process has to be followed perfect. So you must understand when they are buying. Aaj samjha tumhi ek private sector ki te vastu viku gelat. Tya private sector ek tar tumhi owner meltat kiwa hold company ullar to empowered general manager, business manager jo kon urtat dekel budget ache ownership asa tak meltat. But here he talks to you, understands your product and buys from you if he thinks it is good for your his company. He feels it is good for his company because he has some experience, he has some needs, he has seen your product, and he has his own judgment, which his company has empowered him to have, and he gives his opinion. In government, to say that this is a good product and this is the right price, you need to follow a process of tendering. And this is the process which is extremely long. This is the process which takes huge patience. I wouldn't say that you get into government as your sole business, but don't ignore government segment if otherwise you have sustainable business, and if your product has application in government, then don't ignore for the wrong things you hear about government. So do I do business only with government? If your product is such that government only can buy, then you have no choice but to do that. But if your product is such that government can also buy, then my current advice is test the private market, corporate market. If you are into export market, establish well, maintain your cash flows, build your organization, and spend 10% of your time, money, and energy on building government as a customer. So that is how I would like to give my views on government business.
Thank you, Prakash Babu. Actually, khoop question hai thi, sir, with respect to this specific topic. What I'll do is, today I mean, baki je area che prashna gaya, and then maybe if time permits, we can come back. Right? One last question I'll ask, and maybe that will cover a couple of questions that have come from the audience. Right? How banking sector has, I see a lot of resistance from the regulatory bodies in acceptance, especially of the emerging technologies. Right, predictive analytics also. अशी किते उल्ली की तेम का अशी black hole दिसता तो. They feel एक measure कैसे करते. So what is the acceptance of these technologies and trends in the government sector? Is there enough awareness आणि user acceptance?
See, if you know nowadays, the income tax department is using analytics on a very large scale. Okay. So give a very high level answer. Is there appreciation of digital technology like analytics or artificial intelligence? What is predictive analytics? Predictive analytics is nothing but analytics by using a certain economic model, some mathematical model, and forecasting something, right?
Correct.
So per se, Niti Aayog also has made a committee for artificial intelligence. Local governments are driving, state governments are driving blockchain, state governments are focusing. So there is appreciation, okay? But this is a Dudhari Talwar. I'm sure as and when the Homo sapiens must have got after the evolution and they must have invented fire and a sharp edge, the question must be, dilemma must be, can this be used for a wrong purpose? So that dilemma is there for every tool that comes up. So that dilemma exists today, although there are a lot of ethical issues in use of predictive analysis as well as artificial intelligence. It's a totally different topic. I mean, a long discussion can happen on the issues of ethics in artificial intelligence. The simplest example I can give you, which many would be knowing, ki America temi ja padhatine algorithm treat kello, ते जे ब्लॅक लोक असतात नाही त्यामुळे तो चोरूत म्हणतालो म्हटला त्याचं जर कोणी इमेज प्रोसेसिंग करू लागले तर अफ्रो अमेरिकन निग्रो पर्सन उरलो तर द आर्टिफिशियल इंटेलिजन्स लॉजिक यूज टू डिक्लेअर दॅट पर्सन एज अ थीफ नाव दिस हॅपन बिकॉज दॅट पर्टिक्युलर अल्गोरिदम वॉज नॉट ट्रेन्ड प्रॉपरली बिकॉज मेनी पीपल हुम दे माईट हॅव स्कॅन्ड हॅव्हिंग your history sheets or criminal record, they might have been Afro-American. But that does not mean anybody who is dark-skinned is to be branded and in video analytics, that sang chiki ho possible criminal asa. So that was because the algorithm was not treated properly, trained properly. So yes, there is full acceptance and appreciation of digital technology in government, whether it is artificial intelligence, whether it is analytics. आम्ही आता वॉटर बिल्स प्रॉपर्टी बिल्स इन्कम टॅक्स इथून सगळ्या सुद्धा फ्रॉड डिटेक्शन असा रेव्हेन्यू लीक असा वॉट आर द बट द सॉफ्टवेअर डझंट से दॅट दिस पर्सन इज डिफॉल्टेड द सॉफ्टवेअर से दिस पर्सन इज मोस्ट लाईकली टू डिफॉल्ट इन मेकिंग द पेमेंट और दिस पर्सन इज मोस्ट लाईकली टू बिकम अ एनपीए Because it seems from the data which I have collected, he has not given the rent. Utility company says he has not paid the bill. Depending on how what information is being fed to the model. So the safest thing which nowadays people are saying is they come to a shortlist of possible deviations, possible non-compliances, and then the human interface takes over. आता आमगेल केस सुद्धा आम्ही क्रिएट करतात समजा की देयर इज अ सॉफ्टवेअर यूजिंग एनालिटिक्स फॉर लिकेज इन वॉटर आता वॉटर सप्लाय म्युनिसिपालिटीज करतात तर त्यांना प्रोडक्ट काही ठिकाणी कमी हे येतात उत्पन्न येतात तर दे यूज दिस प्रेडिक्टिव्ह अनालिसिस हाऊ डू दे यूज इट आय गिव्ह व्हेरी सिम्पल एक्झाम्पल समजा तुमगेल बिल्डिंग आत चार रेसिडेन्शियल असतात आणि एक ऑफिस असा आणि तुमगेल ऑफिसातले जे पॉवर कनेक्शन असा ते कमर्शियल असा आणि प्रॉपर्टी टॅक्स जो भरता किंवा वॉटर जो भरता तो रेसिडेन्शियल रेटान भरता सो इफ यू प्रोव्हाइड ऑल द इनपुट्स टू द मॉडेल सेइंग दॅट की हे जे फ्लोर असा या फ्लोराचेर वॉटर बिलिंग हे रेसिडेन्शियल रेटान जाता प्रॉपर्टी टॅक्स रेसिडेन्शियल रेटान जाता पण पॉवर मीटर जे असा ते कमर्शियल रेटान जाता सो द सॉफ्टवेअर विल आयडेंटिफाय दीस अँड पीपल हॅव टू गो अँड चेक whether this person is actually running a commercial establishment and he is taking advantage of a domestic rate. So the model which we are going to is, for example, you may be getting an income tax letter that it is learned that last year you did two big investment, but they are not appeared in your income tax returns. Now, they are all examples of analytics. So to answer your question, there is appreciation. This is not to say that there are no issues. There are serious issues issues related to ethics. It's a typical Dudhari Talwar. You want the one who invented gun knew that it can be used for protection or it can be used for killing. That did not stop the manufacture of guns. In the same manner, AI, machine learning is not going to stop. It is here, but ethically, there are a lot of models which are coming out. टू मेंटेन आता तुम्ही जे GDPR ऐकता डेटा प्रायव्हसी ऍक्ट जे आम्ही आरचे असतात ते ऐकतात किंवा द करंट टसल विच इज गोईंग ऑन बिटवीन द सोशल मीडिया कंपनी अँड द गव्हर्नमेंट दे आर ऑल सम काइंड ऑफ अ साइन्स that we are maturing as a information technology society to accept these kind of high risk tools and tame them to ensure that there are comfort and all stakeholders are reasonably satisfied. So there is appreciation, there is use, but there are issues, they are being tackled. That is how I can summarize.
Thank you. Yeah, I think we keep reading about it in the news, but it's very good to get those insights from your side, who is on the other end many times. Sir, again, Prashnam Kampari Setia, sir. I'll try to reach to the more of a last section, right? Jame IT career chalu karte sa dada, right? That time happened. Not necessarily a business, but in job market enter. Sir, 1990s, nala early 2000 pe shishile, ki hardware, networking, software, ashe teen category urta. आणि कोणा भी खय शिल्ले पहिले प्रश्न विचारताल की किती वयचे राईट आणि किती वयचे डिसाइड झाले की एक लिमिटेड सेट आशिले की बाबा हे अभ्यास केलं सी सी प्लस प्लस अभ्यास केलं नेटवर्किंग वरती अभ्यास केलं हार्डवेअर साठी अभ्यास केलं आता किती झालं लास्ट 8 to 10 years 15 years अ लॉट ऑफ चेंजेस हॅव हॅपन्ड इन अ रॅपिड पेस राईट व्हेरी डिस्ट्रप्टिव्ह टेक्नॉलॉजी सेक्टर राईट व्हर्च्युअलायझेशनच इम्पॅक्ट झालं असं हार्डवेअर बिझनेस असेल क्लाऊड इला इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर प्लेयर्स इम्पॅक्ट झाला इव्हन सॉफ्टवेअरात आज कोणतरी कितीतरी शिकता आणि तिथून तो स्किल्ड जाता स्किल्ड जातपर्यंत कितीतरी नवीन येईल तर आज जे मी करिअर एंटर करते ना आय एम व्हेरी शुअर आमच्या समाजात असे बरेच इंजिनियर्स असतात जे मी आता एंटर करू ट्राय करते होते राईट दे माईट बी लुकिंग फॉर एबीएम तर हमका करिअर स्टार्ट कसे की बी इट एज अ मेनली एज अ प्रोफेशन और मे बी इवन एज अ बिझनेस राईट अ स्मॉल बिझनेस वॉट इज युअर ॲडवाईस फॉर देम हाऊ दे कॅन स्टे विथ द ट्रेंड अँड एंटर दिस मार्केट
Approximately how much time do I have to respond to this?
You can take up to 10 to 12 minutes.
Okay, see, it's a very extremely wide-based question and the answer can be very comprehensive. I will try and see how much it can be compressed in the available time. See, let's take some data points. In last 15 months, 65,000 white-collar employees were recruited by the unicorns and sunicorns. Unicorns are the companies whose valuation is already $1 billion. Sunicorns, S-O-O-N, sunicorns are the companies which are likely to become $1 billion in valuation very soon. Now, in last 15 months, the unicorns and sunicorns in India have recruited 65,000 white-collar people. Whereas everybody is talking about the loss of jobs and MSMEs dying, which is correct, economy dwindling, etc. India has produced 24 unicorns in last 15 months. And approximately, I think if the numbers are right, something around 43 sunicorns in last 15 months. So who are these unicorns who are recruiting? It is Zomato. It is Bharat Pay, it is logistics company like Delivery, there are fintech companies. So logistics, fintech, then e-commerce companies, or these are the companies where the recruitment is happening. So there is some tremendous change which is happening in the industry. So we must first appreciate, unlike all earlier times, today, even the big technology companies are not sure about how next future will be like. So competition is no more in I'm talking about at a fairly high level at 40,000 feet. Competition is not to earn market share when it comes to top level people. The competition is to evolve a vision which will be more appropriate for the future about whom everybody is little concerned and there is no unknown. There is a lot of unknowns in the future, and this kind of uncertainty never existed prior to today in our industry. What it means is it's a big opportunity. Now, is it a threat that we don't know how the future is going to be? Depends on how you look at it. Most people feel that it is an opportunity. So there is a lot of business which is happening. The pandemic has completely changed the way businesses happen. Now let's look at what are the trends in which are the key trends which most of us would have heard about that. The first is a very standard which we discuss is data analytics, machine learning, and artificial intelligence. This is the first strong trend. Second trend is RPA, the robotic process automation. The bots वगैरह जो हमें तैयार करता था, tech or BPO सुधा जो उठता था, that is a robotic process automation. Then there is something called as blockchain. Then there is something called as 5G, which is going to come, which will make the communication much higher bandwidth. Then you have virtual and augmented reality. Then you have cyber security. Then you have quantum computing. So if you really look at the various, then you have Internet of Things. Internet of Things, maja vegavega sensor, vegavega tikane lail urtata, data capture karta. So these are the 9 or 10. Then some people also talk about GIS as one of the trends and genomics as one of the trends where you study the genes of the person. So these are the areas where the industry is moving. So these are the 9 to 10 trends where the industry is moving, and that is where the business is going to come from. If you decide to categorize these 9 to 12, like if you include GIS, genomics, etc. also into even, you call it identity verification. That is a big thing which is happening nowadays. Here the 9 to 12 goshti trend, I mean, dharle, that broadly, 2-3 prakarat hai business padtat. Pahila prakar manla ro, automation of your life and work. म्हणलं आमगेल जे आम्ही जे वेगवेगळे सॉफ्टवेअर डेव्हलप करतात, मोबिलिटी वापरतात, क्लाऊड वापरतात. सो दॅट इज वन सेगमेंट ऑफ बिझनेस कॉल्ड ॲट डिजिटायझिंग युअर लाईफ नीड्स. सेकंड इज द स्मार्ट फिजिकल सिस्टीम्स. स्मार्ट फिजिकल सिस्टीम म्हटलं की ते की आता आय ओ टी लायले, सेन्सर लायले, त्याचे वयल्यान तुम्ही इंडस्ट्रीयल इंडस्ट्री 4.0 ज्याक म्हणतात ते असा त्याच्या वेळेला करू शकतात. किंवा तुम्ही लॉजिस्टिक स्मार्ट झालेले असा त्याच्या वेळेला करू शकता. जी आय एस तुम्ही वापरू शकतात. सो द सेकंड सेगमेंट वेअर लॉट ऑफ बिझनेस इज गोइंग टू शिफ्ट टू. आय एम ट्राईंग टू बी व्हेरी कन्साइज. ईच ऑफ दिस टॉपिक इज व्हेरी लॉंग टॉपिक, बट फॉर वॉन्ट ऑफ टाइम आय विल गो लिटल फास्टर. सो देर आर 9 to 12 ट्रेंड्स. दीज 9 to 12 ट्रेंड्स कॅन बी ब्रोकन डाऊन इन टू 2 to 3 बिझनेस एरियाज. वन इज, एज आय टोल्ड यू, इज डिजिटायझिंग द डेली लाईफ नीड्स. Second is the smart physical systems like logistics, GIS. And third is energy. Energy, too, we have renewable energy and we have energy storage. This is the area which is coming up in a big way. Whether it is your mobile or it is the electric cars or autonomous cars, energy storage. Anything ancillary to this is going to give a lot of opportunities to everybody to do business. Now, in India, what is happening? See, India, the digital infrastructure has come up very well. Now, what is the digital infrastructure? One is mobile number. It is available nationally. It is portable nationally. Second is Aadhaar number. It is national number. Third is bank account. It can operate anywhere. And fourth is GST. Now, these are the four things which are applicable all over India. This is the digital infrastructure which we have created. And because we have created this digital infrastructure, the cost of sales of distribution has come down. पहिले एखादी गोष्ट तयार केल्यानंतर, I talked about virtual reality and augmented reality. People are now buying houses in countries abroad just on the VR and AR. म्हणजे augmented reality, तुम्ही virtual reality, ते घर पळतात, आजूबाजू गोष्टी पळतात. And I have seen people signing up. These are the reports in Economist a few months back. So, situation has changed tremendously that today virtual acceptance is increased. There are retail companies where if you send your photograph, you will be able to have a cloth fitted on you. This I was speaking in some other forum in our Kokan Maratha only, I was saying. So there is a huge opportunity for internal globalization. पहिली जी परिस्थिती अशी आहे, महाराष्ट्र, गोवा, कर्नाटक हंग दंद करताना बॉर्डर क्रॉस केल्यानंतर त्रास जात आलो, दॅट डझंट एक्झिस्ट. टुडे इंडिया हॅज बिकम वन मार्केट, हेन्स इंटरनल ग्लोबलायझेशन हॅज स्टार्टेड बिकॉज ऑफ दीज फोर पिलर्स ऑफ द डिजिटल इन्फ्रास्ट्रक्चर. इफ यू हॅव अ गुड प्रॉडक्ट, बी शुअर युअर कॉस्ट ऑफ सेल्स ऑर कॉस्ट ऑफ डिस्ट्रीब्युशन इज मच लेसर नाव बिकॉज पीपल हॅव ॲक्सेप्टेड to buy things online, which is a big paradigm shift which has happened in the consumer behavior. And this is the opportunity which is available to each of the entrepreneur to get into this area. Obviously, each of the area which I mentioned also has huge career scope. The people working in, just to give you idea, people working in RPA, robotic process automation, are commanding, I'm talking about a median salary of $500,000 per annum. म्हणणार 3-3.5 कोटी रुपये तेमगेले आरपीएच्या राईट रिसोर्सा मेळटा किंवा ब्लॉकचेनच्या राईट रिसोर्सा सुमारे 250K म्हणा सुमारे 2-2.5 कोटी पगार मेळटा ऑन द हायर एंड. सिमिलरली द ऑपॉर्च्युनिटी विच कम्स आउट ऑफ दिस इज ह्यूज. इट कॅन बी ॲज मंडेन ॲज डेटा एंट्री, कम्प्युटर सर्व्हिसिंग, कम्प्युटर सप्लाय. सी मायकल डेल वॉज आस्क्ड वन्स अ क्वेश्चन, द होल वर्ल्ड इज मुव्हिंग टू cloud, why are you not defocusing from your business of laptops? He said, if everybody goes to cloud, somebody has to have some device. He said, I'm not going to move away from my end client, that is this particular machine. And if you talk about cloud computing, it is already come down to edge computing. Now, what is cloud computing? Ki ami pratyek goshtu amgel server ar karcha evaji cloud acher kartat, server farm acher kartat, pati to latency build jatat. Tu vichar kar autonomous vehicle asa ti rastyavelan hote asa ani teni immediately samor ek vehicle register keli. Normally autonomous vehicle kis jata ki te sensor urta to object sense karta, क्लाउडाचेर धाडता, क्लाउडा प्रोसेस जाऊन ते परत त्या ऑटोनॉमस वेहिकलकडे येतात आणि आयल्यानंतर ते सिग्नल त्यागल्या मशीना वचून तो ब्रेक मारतात. नाव यू इमॅजिन इन अ फ्रॅक्शन ऑफ सेकंड इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल बिकॉज इज अ लेटन्सी विच बिल्ड्स. हांच्यान सिग्नल थंय वतलो, थंच्यान हंग येतलो. सो वॉट इज हॅपनिंग नाव डेज इज समथिंग कॉल्ड एज कम्प्युटिंग. दॅट इज वन ऑफ द ट्रेंड्स. आय मिस दॅट ट्रेंड. क्लाउड कम्प्युटिंग फाटी गेला आणि एज कम्प्युटिंग आयला. एज कम्प्युटिंग मीन्स कम्प्युटिंग हॅपन्स ॲट द एज ऑन द इन्स्ट्रुमेंट. सो if you look at the kind of in scenario which is evolving, 65% of the jobs which students under age of 15 will be doing are yet unknown. Today 65% of our young population, the job which they will do after they graduate are unknown. There will be new jobs. So there are huge opportunities. Is somewhere the job gets skilled, but somewhere else the job, like people say, robotic process automation म्हणला की तसा की जे बीपीओ उरता त्या बीपीओ जे काम जाता ते बीपीओ काम लोक म्हणतात की जवळजवळ 95% बॉट्स करू शकतले. पण ॲट द सेम टाईम त्या आरपीएची रिलेटेड जे अँसिलरी इंडस्ट्री असा थंय सुद्धा भरपूर स्कोप असा. इफ यू डोंट डू अपस्केलिंग, इफ यू डोंट डू क्रॉस स्किलिंग, then there is going to be problem. So this is where my take is on where we are going, where are the opportunities. Of course, I've gone a little fast, but this is what at a high level I can submit my views.
Thank you. Thank you. So summarize karu gela, basically it's more about getting to know and being aware of the latest trend, right? Market is a kit challa. I think ja IT asa tyanka bare set terms khabar asa, but it's a day-to-day basis are aware of that. I think that's the most important. So a final question, and again a very very generic question from many people, right? Ami technology baddal bolele, but many times thodi lokak bhote ek current market openings ani reach ache thodi limitations hota, right? And we have many engineers in our community. The hamka at sadhya ek market a kuchun enter karcha sa, right? Apply karcha sa. Let's say ABM I apply customer. Is there any basic advice which you would like to give? Because I think many people have asked this question.
Those few trends which I mentioned just now, are available for anybody to know if he does the right search on Wikipedia or even any search engine. There is an additional challenge in last 1-2 years that because of pandemic, the last year of many engineering students has been online, and that has raised questions in the mind of many employers as to what will be the quality of those people. And tamke je mark melat hote genuinely parikshet yun mark melat ki ashet kitari internal jevela mark dilas, there is unfortunately additional challenge. Mark ata ashe dista ki those who are either freshly coming into the market for job, or those who are 4-6 years old in the job, and those who are 20 years old in the job. This is applicable to all the people to understand that the industry has significantly changed. Most of the jobs which were being done by manually or by human beings are being done because of things like robotic process automation, QA, data analytics. The only answer is upskilling. There are abundant methods of upskilling. There is one website by NASSCOM. You should go to the NASSCOM website. And I think they are offering free cross-skilling, upskilling. I'm not sure. Or there are websites like Edureka. There must be many more. An Academy and Byju's maybe for school children. There are a lot of websites which are offering these courses. Lot of companies like Wipro, Infosys have built very robust upskilling and cross-skilling program. They're actually now selling to their customers because there are some of their customers, many of their customers want their staff, their employees also to be upskilled because this digital technology, cloud, edge computing, artificial intelligence, analytics, cyber security, these skills are non-existent. So there is a lot of opportunity to do this kind of a upskilling. Now, ABM is not a company which recruits large number of people because we are into framework business. We are 400-500 kind of a people, but our revenues are not linear. म्हणलं कसं आहे की माका नेक्स्ट बिझनेस हार्टसाठी आय डोंट हॅव टू प्लेस एक्स नंबर ऑफ पीपल देन आय गेट सो मच ऑफ बिलिंग. अवर्स इज अ प्रॉडक्ट काइंड ऑफ अ कंपनी, त्यामुळे एमगेल जे असा ते नॉन लिनियर रेव्हेन्यू मॉडेल असा. म्हणजे आय कॅन मेक 3 सेल्स, बट दोज 3 सेल्स आय कॅन मेक विथ द हेल्प ऑफ सेम टेक्निकल टीम बिकॉज वॉट आय एम डुईंग इज सेलिंग अ मॅच्युअर्ड फ्रेमवर्क ऑफ माय प्रॉडक्ट इन द पर्टिक्युलर स्पेस. When we do 2 kinds of recruitments, one is every year we take some amount of trainees after following a process of technical interview, aptitude interview, and a certain other behavioral test. Those who pass their test, then they are taken interviews. Actually, and then they are onboarded, and then we have a very rigorous training of 4 to 5 months for all those people, and then they are put into the job, and we take three years bond from those people for this kind of a work. That is one method in which we recruit. The second kind of recruiting which happens is from a lateral level. So the delivery management, project management, QA solution architect. किंवा टेक्निकल आर्किटेक्ट या प्रकारचे जे रोल उरतात, हाय एंड फुल स्टॅक डेव्हलपर ज्या म्हणतात, दोज वर इन द इंडस्ट्री विल अंडरस्टँड दिस वर्ड्स, तो फुल स्टॅक डेव्हलपर या प्रकारचे रोल असतात. दॅट इज द रिक्रुटमेंट विच वी डू बाय लॅटरल एंट्री, अँड दिस वी डू बाय स्टँडर्ड मेथड ऑफ लिंक्डइन, नोकरी, दोज काइंड ऑफ दिस थिंग. पण हल्ली एव्हरीबडी मस्ट फोकस ऑन लिंक्डइन बिकॉज आमगेल बऱ्याच लोकांना पहिला की दे आर नॉट अपडेटिंग देअर लिंक्डइन प्रोफाईल, वेअर एज टुडे इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट सक्सेसफुल हिट रेट्स फॉर गेटिंग एम्प्लॉयमेंट इज लिंक्डइन. त्यामुळे पीपल मस्ट अपडेट देअर लिंक्डइन प्रोफाईल, गिव द राईट मेसेजेस ॲट राईट प्लेस सो दॅट दे गेट द इंटरव्ह्यू कॉल्स from various companies. So have I answered your question properly, Kiran?
Yes. Hmm. I think you covered almost all the points.
Yeah.
In fact, unknowingly, we have actually answered quite a few of the questions that were asked by the audience. Ek last question now, Geta, and this is I'm taking this specifically because ami agriculture related to amgelik series server. Right? So this is asked by Sachin from Mumbai. He's asking about the outlook and the opportunities with respect to using IT and big data by the government or by other bodies, mainly for the agricultural sector. Any thoughts or views with respect to this?
It's a very interesting question. As I told you, we are into a particular segment. Then I acquired a company in cybersecurity. So that is our subsidiary. Actually, the next company which I want to, next startup which I want to acquire is actually in the space. There are priorities which I have decided. The first priority, not in that order, GovTech, AgriTech, and HealthTech. These are the three. So AgriTech is indeed one of the areas where even I am focusing on developing that. But there are something which you must understand about agri-tech. Farmers don't pay for your services. So your model has to be something where you get money other than charging farmers, because that is not how you can make money in agri-tech. So what are the various ways? I have examined 8 to 10 agritech startups. There are very interesting models people have. Somebody has a camera which is fitted onto drone, and that camera can capture the pests on the leaves much before a human eye can capture it. And then he actually communicates this to the farmer as well as the pesticide companies. And the farmer is able to buy the pesticide from the pesticide company much before the pest spreads into his field. And the company makes money from the pesticide supplier in terms of their margins, as well as if he significantly increases the yield of the farmer, which he has shown me that he is doing it, then he is able to get some kind of a compensation from the farmer for the increased sale. So he sells the produce. So on one hand, he gives him the inputs like fertilizer, etc. So the fertilizer company gets non-existent business. Then he sells the produce of that particular farmer as a first right of refusal. So he makes some margin there. This is one model. There is another model where somebody has created a marketplace for buying and selling. So he has created there is a very particular model which works in distribution and retail companies in terms of fertilizers. Now, this particular company which he has developed a technology where he's going hyper-local. Hyper-local means that if you in one area, there are two or four distributors. But the rest of retailers are very high. If you have a farmer who has fertilizer, then you have to waste it. So, you have to do it. So, you have hyper-localization. So, the people who have retailers छोटे पकड़ लाते हैं और टेम्पकन तो मटेरियल सेल करता है और फार्मर्स डू नॉट हैव टू ट्रैवल नाउ टू द सेंट्रल प्लेस फार्मर्स कैन विदाउट स्पेंडिंग देयर टाइम आइदर कैन बाय द मटेरियल एट देयर डोरस्टेप और देयर आर बिजनेस पार्टनर्स व्हिच दे हैव अपॉइंटेड इट्स अ वेरी इनोवेटिव मॉडल सो एग्रीटेक हैज ह्यूज स्कोप देयर आर वेरियस मॉडल्स बट नेवर बिल्ड योर मॉडल ऑन समथिंग वेयर द फार्मर विल पे यू Farmer will pay you in complete indirect manner. He will allow you to sell his goods where you can make money. He will buy the inputs through you where you will get commission from those people, or you will have to create a marketplace where people are coming and selling like APMCs, etc. within the ambit of the law, and there you can make money. So to answer the question, yes, agri-tech is a tip to be extremely high growth area, but one has to be extremely careful while building the revenue models.
Thank you, Prakash. I think many people might try to get in touch with you now, especially since your interest is also there.
Yeah.
Okay. Sure. So last few minutes, it's we're trying to have some rapid fire questions. So Ankit Kardal hetu thao, maybe to take short question vicharatal tumka, and or maybe just give a word, and you have to just answer in a single line. Should not take more than 5-7 minutes. Can we start?
Yeah, sure. As long as you don't ask me very difficult questions, because my wife may be listening.
Sure. I'll take care of that. Your inspiration?
See, my inspiration comes from three people. Sachin Tendulkar for his professional commitment for the excellence. Roger Federer for the grit which he shows. And the soldier on the border who is willing to do the supreme sacrifice on call of duty. I think these three people, I find them very inspiring.
Awesome. Most important trait of a leader?
Ownership. You need to own it. Show the way and lead by example.
Excellent. Which one thing gives you sleepless nights?
Angry customer.
Okay. How do you spend your free time? If you have any.
I have a lot of free time. I don't know why people have this feeling that I actually have a lot of free time. But I spend most of the time either in listening to music. Nowadays, I got addicted to those very short videos which come on Facebook. And actually, I sleep. So these are the three things which I do.
Friendship.
A treasure where agenda is to meet and there is no agenda in the meeting.
Wow. I like that. And this is the first time I heard this definition. India.
A budding superpower with a fabric of real secular, democratic, and deep cultural heritage.
Thanks. A book that you can read again and again.
It will sound as a political correct answer, but I like to read when I can Bhagavad Gita. I find it gives answers to almost all questions. Or listen to that, audiobooks.
Nice, very nice. Okay. How long does it take you to get ready?
See, my getting ready means bathing to wearing clothes. So that takes me 30 minutes.
Favorite kokri dish?
Ukri tandoor, sola kadi, and ek bangdaj kismuri.
Favorite movie?
मग ऑल लाईट कॉमेडी मुव्हीज आय लाईक हिंदी अँड इंग्लिश मग अंगूर सारखे पिक्चर असे लॉन्च करून संजीव कुमार आलो आता दोज हु आर ट्रॅकिंग दॅट ग्रोन अप्स आणि हँग ओव्हर म्हणून काही एक दोन चार इंग्लिश पिक्चर आहेत दोज काइंड ऑफ मुव्हीज सो एनिथिंग विच इज लाईट अँड कॉमेडी लाईक सब टी व्ही काइंड आय हॅव द कल्ट ऑफ सब टी व्ही वे आर व्हेरी सिम्पल कॉमेडी उरतात येतो सो एनी लाईट कॉमेडी इज वॉट आय लाईक Yeah, those kind of Rishikesh Mukherjee kind of thing.
One of your favorite songs that makes you feel like a teenager?
Ruk jana nahi tum kahin aa rakhe kaato pe chalte milenge raah that Imtihan movie Vinod Khanna's song I heard it when I was undergoing some kind of I think college politics or something I don't remember so that song has got ingrained into me.
One thing that you like about I'll take three names here.
Karwar. The pristine beauty, the greenery and the sea.
Maharashtra.
I like the simplicity of people in Maharashtra, irrespective of how high they are on intellect or finance.
India again.
I like India. There are many questions which ask me why didn't you go abroad. I think no, I can't because I think it's inseparable for India. If you ask me one word, it can be inseparable.
Finally, before we close, Prakash Babu, if not IT and ABM, what would Prakash Rane have been known for?
Extremely honestly, I don't know. One thing is sure that it would have been in some business. It could not have been job. That's why, honestly, I don't. I never thought in those that direction.
Thank you, Prakash Babu, on behalf of KME team and entire Maratha Samaj.
Kiran,
yes,
we have Kamlash Kaka on board. So if he wants to ask any questions, Kamlash Kaka?
Definitely.
Kamlash Kaka, mute your mic.
Kamlash Kaka? Let me ask him one.
Okay.
Yes.
Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Hi, Kamlash Kaka, I can hear you.
Yeah, there's no special question. I was only concerned because he's in a different business than my business. My business is all hardware, you know. It's a problem, which is a headache business. Everybody feels his own business is headache business. That is also true. I don't know, because he was also earlier in hardware business. It's a good thing he has done. Yeah. He left all this. And started, which is also tough, no doubt. He's a bread butter. He's totally different.
Yeah.
But he picked up very well whatever he has done. God alone knows the kind of time he has put into this kind of business. He has really come up. It is a really proud thing for us, you know. So there is no question as such, but I think now government is giving a lot of importance for the manufacturing and make in India.
Yes.
So there should be something, you know, that we should do now. The young people should enter into manufacturing. And you will not believe a lot of talks are going on. Even foreign countries are coming. Next week, one US guy is coming to my place in this condition. You can imagine. A lot of, I think there's a lot of scope. Now it is time to really make in India and slowly forget China. No doubt, we're dependent on China because of the detailed parts are not at all available here, but things will happen. But somebody has to take initiative, that is government, which is not taken at all, because I'm in the industry for the last 40 years, so I know. Thank you, Arvind. It's very nice talking to, I mean, all hearing from you, on one-sided, no doubt. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you, Kamla.
Thank you, Kamesh. Again, thank you, Prakash Bhav, on behalf of entire KME team and entire Open Maratha Samaj for your valuable time and sharing your experience.
Thank you very much. Thanks for inviting me. It was a pleasure being a part of this. I hope the audience find it useful. And if not, my apologies.
No, I think it was really very informative and inspiring, at least for me personally. And I'm very sure it, the same goes for all. Wishing you and ABM the very, very best in your future.
Thank you very much. Thanks, everybody.